Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Monique here. If you are new, welcome. I would love for you to become a part of the family here. So if you enjoy anything art related, please subscribe down below. Any support is very, very much appreciated. So for today's video, I am going to be drawing a picture of Rick Grimes from The Walking Dead. Now this will be a graphite realism portrait, and it's a little bit different than any other portrait I've done thus far because it's gonna be done on a 14 by 17 piece of paper compared to the traditional 9 by 12 piece of sketchbook paper that I usually use. So because this is a bigger size piece of paper, the larger scale allows me, due to the surface area being larger, to have more space to put more detail into this piece, like pores, which you'll see me create at the end of this video. But it's really awesome because now I'm pulling elements from hyperrealistic styles and photorealism styles into this traditional realism piece. So I worked really, really hard on this one, and I really hope you guys enjoy this video. Thank you. Hey guys, so you made it to the end of the video. Thank you so much for just sticking around and watching it. I know this was a long one, and it was long because this portrait did take me 13 hours to do. So the biggest piece of advice I just have is to take your time as usual. It seems to be the theme here with realism portraits, but for real though, like seriously, sit down, do a couple of hours, do a half hour even. Do your piece, work on it, and take a step away from it. Make sure to take breaks. And you know, there's times where we could even experience blocks as artists, not just with creative pieces, even when you're doing a piece that you're using a reference photo for. You can experience blocks to the point where you don't even wanna keep on working on the piece. Can anybody relate with me? Like, I know with me, sometimes like 5 hours into the drawing, I'm just like, I'm over it. Like, I wish the piece would be done. And that is the worst thing that can happen, because if you get to that point where you're sick of it, not only are you gonna ruin what you love to do for yourself, but you're gonna wanna rush through the rest of the piece, which is not good, because you'll see the parts of the piece that really show the time that you put into it. And then you'll see the parts that you rush just because you wanted to get it done. So that's the biggest piece of advice I have. Spend time with family, friends, do things you love, relax, and then come back to it. You would be so surprised how much more rejuvenated you feel when you take those breaks to just relax and do things that you love, and then return back to it. But I just use tools like Q-tips. I used a wide variety of different pencils today. I usually love to use just my HB mechanical pencils, but I used all the way from a 2B up to a 12B pencil because this had a lot of darks and lights in it. I used blending stumps, Q-tips, paint brushes, but most importantly, the newest tool that I used here was a tissue, which is may sound crazy, but all of those other blending tools can sometimes leave the skin especially looking a little streaky, especially if you're still getting used to the just using light pressure with your hand. But wrapping the tissue around your finger and then softly just going over the skin really, really makes it look so much more smooth and soft. So I highly recommend you guys trying out a tissue if you haven't done so yet, just to kind of be the final like blending piece on your artwork. So that's all the tips and tricks that I have for you guys, just things that I learned. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe down below if you haven't done so yet. Leave a comment, give this video a like if you enjoyed it, and I hope you guys all have a beautiful day.